you hear me?
No. What are you doing over there?
I'm eating a Reese's Bell.
I'm trying to catch you humming. I wasn't ready to do the show. I'm opening a beer over here. Not ready. I'm never ready for the show.
This has been our theme song for so long, and I still don't know the words. I can't understand him.
We all go down to the sacrificial moment. Do you remember? Am I here? I sound different. Do I sound different, or am I actually here? I can't tell.
I don't know. I can hear you.
All right. I have to get my beer open. Can't do the show without beer. No one can except Tori. Because she's in a relationship with Hunter, so she's a robot.
No, I'm just not 21, so you won't give me anything.
Ooh, I'll give you something, Tori. Oh, where's the good soundbite?
Why is it so large? Why does it have to be that big?
That's right, Tori. It's my penis. Get used to it.
You lost your head, so what'd you do?
My hair is bothering me. It's like underneath.
You could have used a cough button for that. I gave Tori a jizz button.
Oh.
Does it work?
It does.
I was going to play you Brett singing, but I don't know where it is.
Me either.
The words of the song. Do you want to hear it or no?
Not really.
All right, cool.
Do you miss Brett?
I don't think about it. Honestly, I'm so self-centered. I stop thinking about people as soon as they stop doing the show. I just forget about people.
It's harsh.
It is. It's hard for me, though. I'm so focused on myself, though. I can't thread on the past. Look at me try to use big words and fail right off the bat.
Well, I follow him on Snapchat still, so I like still see his story and stuff. Weird.
Did I follow him on Snapchat before the show? No, I don't think I did. I followed him on maybe Instagram, which he wasn't a big poster on. God, I'm dealing with the scene. I'm a disaster, so I eat about 4 Butterfingers before the show starts. So I ate a Butterfinger and I gashed open the side of my mouth. And I looked and it was bleeding, and I was spitting out orange, and it turned red because I was eating the Butterfinger, so I couldn't tell until the Butterfingers went away. And somebody, it was so gross. But then I realized I had bit myself, and it's right in the, you know.
Yeah.
It just fucks with me.
And then like it swells up, so you bite it again and
I try not to actually open my teeth before the show so that we would kind of heal. My teeth wouldn't rub against it, but now I'm just going to do the show. I'm going to cut it all open. But it's for the show. So, lots of sacrifices for the show. I'm gonna try to drink a lot of water. Let me rinse out my mouth real quick. I feel like if I keep it clean, it'll be good. I'm so excited. Tori has a cough button now. It's officially called the jizz in the throat button. So you can, whenever you get jizz stuck in your throat.
Jizz in your throat button.
Which, by the way, Tori doesn't like Hunter's jizz in her mouth. I have that in my notes. But maybe we'll get to that in a second. You just celebrated. Oh god, the show's getting. I feel like I just got bored with my own show. Oh fuck! Oh shit! I did. I started. I was like, oh no! Whoever's listening is gonna tune out immediately.
If I can't even stay engaged, who can?
Should we put lotion on your ass today? Are you gonna do that?
Do you want me to?
Oh my god, I will. I'm gonna spit water all over the place. Because you'll have to. What you have to do is because the thing barely reaches. You'll have to do it right outside this door.
Okay.
You fine with that?
Yeah.
Yeah, because I was going to set up mics in the bathroom if you weren't cool with that, but
I'm
fine with that?
Yeah. Right.
I'll do it too.
Okay.
So what did we even... All right, so I guess I should give the backstory.
Yeah.
Do you want to give the backstory?
Sure. I guess
so. Because
I
can't talk. So if you do it wrong, I'll cut in.
I don't know. Should I start from like way back?
I'm going to try to rest a lot during the show. I'm going to let this be your show, Tori.
Should I start from like the way beginning?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so a while ago...
Tori, we have an hour to kill. What the fuck?
True.
Ryan
Snapchat? Was talking about how he had these weird, like, I don't know if they were like milia bumps or pimples or just dry skin or whatever on his butt. And I was like, dude, I get those too.
Everything about me is just awful.
And he was, me too. And he was talking about how this like specific Aveeno lotion.
It's right behind you.
Is it the oatmeal lotion?
I have it stocked in the studio. You can grab it. It's the daily moisturizing lotion. It's behind you. I have lots of jizzes behind you.
Behind me?
Yeah, behind you I have a lot of jizzes.
Tori hit herself. I don't see it.
I'm going to snap a picture of all the jizzes that Tori has next behind her monitor. But she
can't find it.
Hand sanitizer, and then she has lotion and tissues behind her. I'll snap it out.
Okay.
Where's that? Where's my camera?
Here we go.
She has a bunch of jizzes behind her. Here, let me snap this.
Okay, so daily moisturizing lotion.
I'm snapping. Go. Oh, you were gonna read the thing.
So it's dermatologist recommended. Anyways, he was talking about how he gets like these bumps all over or on his butt or whatever.
It was just like you couldn't even like pop them. They weren't like pimples or anything. They're just like little bumps.
Yeah, I get the same thing. So I was
honestly,
like,
they were probably like goosebumps, but probably not. I'm really gross.
But he was like, oh, yeah, this stuff really cleared it up. So the other, like, this was, like, a few weeks ago. I was like, hey, can I, like, what's that lotion? Can you, like, send me a picture?
And I'm like, oh, we're you know, me and Tori are girls now. We can hang out. I'm like, I'm going to give you some of my lotion. I feel like that's
in a bag.
Yeah.
In a
so
Ziploc bag.
I took the Ziploc bag, and I squirted about 5 or 6 pumps into it. And I just told her how many pumps there were, so she wouldn't apply too much lotion. Usually about one pump is good. And
then I cleaned out my car and I accidentally threw it away.
Yeah, so I gave her a bag of white jizz. And she was going to put it on her ass. And I was going to ask her how it was, but she never ended up applying it to her butt, which made me sad. So what happened? It was in your car and it was all what?
Well, it was in my car. And then like I did like a huge like car clean out because you know how fucking messy my car gets.
And you threw it away.
And I threw it away on accident. Sorry, Ryan.
By the way, Tori's snapping out from the Beer Radio show. Snap account, and my cat is behind me or next to me, and he drools, and he just drooled all over my leg. So now I'm trying not to vomit, and I drool over my leg. I love you, Rusty, but you're so close to death. It's frightening.
Oh man,
he survived the year.
If he drooled on me, I would throw up.
What's
probably
gonna survive longer, my cat or this show? I have no idea. It's open bets. But so I was like, hey, maybe we should apply lotion. I'm going to apply it to mine, but I want to see how mine is, my butt.
Yeah, I haven't really taken a good look at my butt recently.
Look at mine right now. Don't you look, Tori. This isn't for you.
How are you going to look at it without a mirror?
Can you see my butt like right now? Because have to almost kind of like do this. Good.
No.
Can I show the camera? No, I can't. Let's see. Let's see if I can look at my butt without being on camera. Can you see it now, though?
I can only see it if I, like, look specifically at it.
If I do this.
And I won't look at it.
What about now? Can you see it?
No.
Is my butt going to show? All right, let's see. Let's take a look at my butt. All right, let's see. God, there's, like, a birthmark there. It's weird. Look at this birthmark.
I can't. You told me not to look at your butt.
All right, don't look at it. No. Don't look at it. You're a lady.
I want to see the birthmark.
I forget I saw Tori's boobs once. It was a fun show. We were doing the show, and I asked her to show me her piercing, and she did. What a lady. All right, let me check the other cheek. All right, let's see. Oh, God. So gross. See, I got one little bread bump. I don't know what that is, though. I'm so hairy.
Oh.
God, I'm like an animal. Ugh.
Are you seeing this, Rusty?
Yeah, Rusty, don't look.
I'm sure Rusty has seen much worse.
God, that tired me out, looking at my butt. Ugh, it's a stretch, and... Oh, I'm not limber anymore. I can't do the show. It's so hard. What if I just never get on mic for the show? I'm just gonna stay over here. How you doing, Tori?
Good.
What's up? Oh. So I'm going to apply some lotion to mine, too. So I just wanted to check, see if I needed lotion. I need a little lotion. I see one thing, though, and I'm not going to remember where it is, so I'll probably say it went away, even though it didn't. But how's yours right now? Is it messed
up? I don't know.
Up?
I have to look at it.
Go in the bathroom right now and take a look at it. Just because there's a mirror in there. You can take off your headset because that won't reach. But
okay, be right back, guys.
Yeah, you're gone. Actually, let's see. Well, hold on. Stay with me real quick. I wonder if I can get a mic prepared really fast. Let's see if I can do this. Do this during the show.
This is weird.
I don't know my mics. I don't even know. Well, let's see. I used to keep them in. Now, oh, I'm just entangled. Oh, and it hurt my leg. Give me some of that lotion. No, I squirted it in my hand. Ugh. My leg just rubbed on this dry wood of this chair. And it scratched it, so I'm applying some lotion to it.
Vino, sponsor this show.
Yeah, Vino, get on this show. This is a good program. All right, I'm looking at my dress. Tell people what I'm doing.
Okay, I can't really see, but he's looking for a microphone, I assume. He's looking through this drawer, and I believe he found one.
I did. I found a couple.
Okay, he found one.
All right, cool. I have a microphone. I went to Mike Tori in the bathroom. But let's see. I've got a cable down here. I'm so prepared for the show.
This is very last minute.
All right, here we go. Here's the microphone. Let's say testing, testing, test, test. Ooh, look at this. So I can, I'm going to point this mic in the, over here while you apply the lotion. So you, I'm going to have Tori go to the bathroom. All right, I'm getting confused with all these microphones. I can't even do my own goddamn show. It's ridiculous. I'm going to take this microphone and I'm just going to put it in the bathroom. I think it'll work. Let's see if we can do this. Describe to y'all into what I'm doing. This is ridiculous. I'm taking a microphone stand.
And he's, by the way, I don't know if you guys know, but he can't fucking touch anything.
No. It has a paper. I'm using it as a paper towel.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I thought it was just a jizz cloth.
No. I can touch these.
Apparently. He's going to the bathroom and play. He is kneeling on the floor for some reason. He's trying to get this thing to what?
All right, there's now officially a microphone in the bathroom.
Okay, am I going now?
Yeah, go in the bathroom right now, and then just leave the door open. Take some. Just I want to go look at your butt. I just want to see what it looks like. I do want to see what it looks like. Can I see what it looks like? Really? All right, it's fine. God, I wish I had a camera in there too. All right, Tori's going to the bathroom. Let's put this mic up and see if we can do this.
Can I bring the lotion too or no?
No, just don't trip over the microphone.
I'm not.
Wait, say hello.
Hello?
Can you hear me? Yes! Oh my god, the acoustics in there is amazing.
Okay.
Oh my god, would you poop on mic?
No.
What are you doing right now? Describe it.
No.
Are you looking? Can you see in the mirror? Are you?
Yeah.
So what did you do? You pulled your pants down?
I could probably use some lotion.
You pulled your pants down?
Yeah.
So right now you're standing in my bathroom, staring at your ass in the mirror.
Not anymore.
Can you do it again?
No.
I'm not looking. I just want it to keep happening for the audience. This is amazing.
I gotta look at the other side.
What do you got on your? So what do you have on your butt? You just have some bumps?
Yeah.
I love this bathroom microphone. See, whoever doesn't listen to this show fucking misses out. It took 30 seconds for that, but this is the funniest bit. I'm never not having a microphone in the bathroom. I just wanted to talk. I should have you stay out there. It's so funny to have you being out there. What are you doing now?
I'm fixing my hair. Oh. Why is there ice in your sink?
I emptied out my ice thing.
Oh. All right. Do I stay in here or come back?
You can come back.
Okay.
I swear to God, it sounds so funny. It's the best. Oh my God, Troy, this show is so good. I swear.
We need a gold here.
All right, Troy's pinning on my friend. I'm muting her mic so she doesn't hear all the noise. There it is. There she's back. Oh my God, Troy, that's so funny.
You have the ability to mute me?
Yeah.
Why don't I have the ability to
mute me?
Yeah.
I can make it. I can give you that. I can mute anyone. I can mute Katie even though she's not here. We had fun. Katie does not like being told she has boring stories.
No.
It's so good.
Surprised, like, she's going to quit.
You weren't here last week when it happened. Were
yes,
you?
Yes, I was.
You were on Skype, though, yeah. Right? Oh, my God. That was so uncomfortable, the fact that you weren't in studio. Tori was on this fucking fake monitor behind me, so I'm like, God, I have no one to actually save me. Oh, my God. It got so fucking bad.
How was it after the show? Was it so
awkward?
It was all right.
We kind of just didn't talk. You know what I mean? It was kind of, you know, we did, but, like, you know, it was so, oh. But I'm writing a song about her. Do you want to hear? She's not here, so I'll save it for Monday, but do you want to hear some of the... I was in my bathroom recording myself. Oh, I don't have it on here, do I? Motherfucker. All right, good. That's actually really good.
Is she not going to be on Tuesdays anymore?
She's going to be on Mondays for sure, always. And for sure, always, for sure. Totally. And then Tuesdays she'll be here on occasion, too. But it's like having people in
don't
studio.
Don't fucking drool on me, you little Rusty. Ass. Mm-mm. Don't drill on me, I'll kill you.
Rusty's ruining the show lately. He has Alzheimer's, so he forgets he's in here and so he keeps coming back.
How do you know that your cat has Alzheimer's?
I don't know, I forgot. Alright, I'm gonna go in the bathroom now and because I really didn't get to see myself.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna take a look at myself.
Okay.
Alright, I can't hear anything. Let's see, I think I can do this. I'm gonna turn on this mic. I'm gonna turn
Describe to the audience what I'm doing.
Okay. He's walking to the bathroom.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Isn't that funny?
Yes.
Isn't this honestly the funniest thing you've ever heard?
It sounds like a bathroom.
It is a bathroom.
I know, but you can tell because it's like echoey.
Isn't that the best? This show is so good, Tori.
So what are you doing, Ryan? Describe.
Ryan, I pulled down my pants. I'm looking at that birthmark.
Okay, how far down? Like,
oh, I'm so hairy.
Below the ass cheek?
No, I'm actually pulling my cheeks apart for no reason right now. I am. I don't know why I am. I want to look, make sure there's no duty back there. There's none. I have one spot, though, on my left cheek, right in the center.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little... Look at this.
Oh, my God.
I just showed Tori my butt. But you see the bump? Or
no!
You're so terrified by my butt. I had to run back. I looked at Tori in the actual studio, but I had to run back into the bathroom where the microphone was so I could let you all hear it at home. But I ran into the room, I showed Tori my butt, and then she was so scared she didn't even see my mark. So now I'm gonna have to show it to her again.
Okay.
No, I'm not going to.
I was not ready.
You were like that, didn't you?
No.
Is that good for you? Did you finish? Are you wet now, Tori?
No. Oh. It's like the Sahara
Desert.
Is that why
there's ice cubes in the sink?
That doesn't make any sense.
Because you're so... I don't know. Not hot. I don't know. The joke.
Yeah.
Isn't that funny though? That bathroom mic.
Yes.
Was I? Yeah, I was yelling, wasn't I? But I was trying to be on mic. Always a broadcaster. So I need to apply lotion. Let's get this. I'm bored with this bit. Go apply lotion to yourself. Come on. This is ridiculous.
Apply lotion to my butt.
Or do you want me to do it first? I'll do it first. All
right, you can do it.
Oh, I just sat down though. Hold on, let me drink.
I'll do it. How long does it take to like soak in?
Let's do this now because I got a lot to talk about. Then we got to go to break. Well, then we'll come back after break. And then how long does it take to soak? You'll probably have a damp butt, but you can take some tissues if you want. I actually would recommend just putting a little bit, taking mm-hmm. one little like a half pump,
mm-hmm.
and then just apply it.
Okay.
Less is more with this, I think.
All right.
Tori's taking off her microphone. Let's turn on the bathroom mic again. Just take. Are you taking it with you?
Oh yeah.
You can take it with you. All right.
I was going to.
Go ahead. And now she's going to the bathroom. Don't trip up on that mic, please.
I won't.
And not have any insurance. Don't forget you're mic'd in there so we can hear you.
Okay. Can you hear this?
I heard the little... Yeah, I think so.
You think so?
I don't know. I heard something.
Rusty.
Maybe that's Rusty. Is he rubbing
this
against
so
the...
so awkward, Rusty.
Is Rusty in my bathroom watching you apply lotion to your butt?
Yeah.
Oh my God, this is the best. Don't use Rusty to dry off.
I won't. This is so strange. Also, the door isn't closed, so I'm just in your house.
Naked.
Not naked,
ooh.
But...
Oh, yeah.
Oh, now he's walking through my legs.
So what'd you do? Did you just pull down your pants a little bit?
Yeah, just enough that my butt is exposed.
Is your vagina exposed, or...?
Not really.
Not really? A little bit?
Well...
Do you have a bush?
No.
Okay.
But I am wearing a thong, so I don't really need to pull my underwear down to, like, apply the lotion.
Oh. All right, so, but you, all right.
Was that too much information?
No, I'm just trying to figure out what's going on. Are you missing anything, though?
No. Thong it's hard to put my pants back on, though.
Because of the lotion?
Yeah.
You were, what are you, kind of pants are you wearing? Jeans?
Yeah.
You wear jeans with a thong?
Yes.
So isn't your butt just on a on jean?
Yeah.
Isn't that weird?
No.
How is that not weird? If my butt touched my pants out, it'd be like not having pants on. You don't feel like it's just not having pants on?
Not having underwear on?
Yeah.
I mean, sometimes I don't wear underwear, so...
Stay in the bathroom.
Okay. So it's not that different.
I think I saw you... You can come back in here. I remember seeing... Hunter showed me one of Tori's thongs. It's kind of nice.
Oh, is that when he had my underwear in his backpack?
Yeah, he had your underwear in his backpack. It was actually pretty nice. I like seeing it. It wasn't, you know. Honestly, I thought it was going to be like this big slingshot. It was real small. There's quite a lady down there.
How does he remember these things?
I remember everything.
I left the lotion in there for you.
Oh, so I got to go do it now?
Yeah. Or we can just move on.
Now you just have the lotion on your butt? I want to see what it does, though.
I don't know. You said not to apply a lot, so I didn't apply a lot.
I'll do it in here, though, because I'm a man. I don't care. Is it funnier in the bathroom, though?
Yeah.
Because of the microphone? Mm-hmm. All right. Is that mic still on? I can't tell.
The lotion's in there?
Yeah.
All right. Can you hear me?
Yes.
All right. Very good. I got to turn this light on. All right. Let's see. Let's see what the business is back here. Pulling down my pants.
So are you just applying it to that one spot?
I'm taking a little bit and I'm just putting it on my finger. And yeah, I'm just going to put it on that one spot, I think, and around it. But do you think it's too much just to keep, you know, apply it all? Is it too much?
What do you mean?
I feel like if you, it's going to just like absorb into it and make the pore bigger.
I don't know. It's your thing. You told me it works, so. I'm eating another Reese's. What the fuck?
I'm trying to pee now. It's not working.
Oh, so you could pee on...
Yeah, I wanted to try to pee on the radio.
I could pee on the mic.
Do you have to pee?
A little.
Will you pee on mic? Hold on. Listen. How's it sound? Is it funny sound?
Yes.
Alright, I'm going to try to be quiet. Say we have to pee that much, but I wanted to...
Did you just fart?
No.
I heard
it too. Before the show started, I knew I had to pee, and I'm like, maybe I'll do it during break, but then I came in here, and I'm like, well, maybe. You know how you get to go into the bathroom, and you're like, alright, maybe I have to pee now?
Mm-hmm.
I have that happening. Hold on, let's see.
Are you nervous? Are you camera shy?
Well, no, I have to, like, push on it, but usually I'll, like... I usually want to pee at this stage.
Push on what?
I'm forcing to pee, so I'm like grunting a little bit. So I'm trying not to grunt. I'm trying not to grunt over the pee sound. So I have to grunt before I do it to like get it up.
All right.
All right, hold on. All right, it's coming out. Oh, I have to push so hard.
That's not good.
Well, like I said, I don't really have to pee, but there's... My bladder has something in it.
Right. So you're just forcing it.
I'm forcing my bladder. This probably isn't good. Please call in if you're a doctor.
Rusty is so confused.
Your fucking ghost grandpa isn't here today. He's fucking fired, I swear. I'm not happy about this at all. How are you doing with your grandpa, by the way?
I'm fine.
Really?
Yes.
It was weird for me, like, the first couple days, but as soon as after the funeral happened and everything, like, it was in the ground, I was kind of like, all right, I'm done.
Yeah. Well, plus, there was a lot of time, like, in between him dying and the funeral. So, yeah, I'm fine.
All right, you got more.
Oh, my goodness.
Ugh.
This sounds so strange.
All right, I think that's enough. And then I pushed on my prostate a little bit. Make sure I get everything out.
Isn't the only way you can touch your prostate is through your asshole?
No, that's the underneath.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
You push on the taint.
Uh-huh.
It's that bathroom. All right, goodbye, bathroom. God, do you like the bathroom, Mike? That's fun.
I do. It's funny. We should do a show in the bathroom.
Is it fun and funny? It's not fun. It's not fun. This isn't fun. No, I don't even know the thing. I can't do it. It's not fun. It's not funny. I think that's Woody Allen. I have no idea. I'm going to do some research. What is that from?
What?
It's not fun. It's not funny. Billy Crystal versus... Oh, that's what it is. It's a Billy Crystal versus Stuttering John from the Stern Show. I thought it was him actually saying it.
Who are you?
How's it going?
From where?
From XRK. Are you glad that you're the only guy who can handle the Oscars?
I'm not the only guy who can handle the Oscars.
Well, David didn't do as good a job as you, Bill.
David did great. I love what David did on the show. He was terrific.
Oh, will there be a Mr. Saturday Night, too?
Yes, there will.
Oh, yeah? Okay. How many years were you married before you cheated on your wife?
So you can take this to Howard, right? And you can shove this right up Howard's stupid f- ass, okay?
Well, you don't like Howard anymore, Bill?
No, because Howard dumps on me all the time, and, you know, it's just not fun when you have a thing like this, okay? And now you'll do this on a show, and you'll all laugh and have a good time, but it's not fun, you know?
Well, Billy, we're all big fans of yours, Bill. Yeah, right. No, so I, really, I'm a big fan of yours.
Good. Then you don't come in and sell stuff.
Yeah. All right, sorry, I thought that was funny. Never mind.
I want a punchki.
I never knew what that was from. I almost got him order it sent here from our friends at Uber, but I was it didn't work. So I try again?
I want one. If not, I'm going to get one after the show.
It's on the thing where it's like, it's unavailable, check back soon, but I don't know what, I like pressed, like, request anyways, but I don't know what that does. Is it going to send it to me at like 9 o'clock tonight? And then it's not like letting me put in my address. So I don't know.
Well, I can like go to Kroger or something and get them. So it's fine. It's Fat Tuesday though.
I want a Poonski.
I'll bring one back to you.
That's not fun. That's not funny. Let's see. And so what happens if I just confirm pickup? See, I don't know how to do that. It's confusing. All right, I'm not going to do this on the show. Oh, I just had it right, and I did it wrong. All right, here's my address. Blah, 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 blah. It's hard because I want to say it out loud, but I can't. God, I was reading the newspaper today.
Okay.
I was. More than 5 years ago, Anthony Verlez and Rosemary Chez were found murdered. I guess the headline is a reward offered for a information on murdered Macomb County couple. The young couple's bodies were found on October 24th, 2011. This was, what, 6 years ago? In a vacant lot on Detroit's east side. Chez of Clinton Township was 19 years old. She graduated from our high school. She was attending Macomb at the time of her death. An employee described as a typical American girl. I remember sitting next to this girl in gym class.
That's so weird.
Yeah. Her boyfriend was 21, sold projector parts. And I was like looking it up, like what happened. It's actually sad. I don't know why I'm talking about it, but it was just kind of weird. But then I can't remember her being kind of like a bitch to me.
So you're like, I don't fucking care. So,
I swear, this is what happens when people are dicks to me. And then I had another kid too, Nick Ivanovic. Ended up being the sweetest guy to me. Like, you know, towards the end of high school. But I remember like the first weeks of ninth grade. I got so made fun of. I just remember him. I was in a science class with him, and we got partnered up. And he goes, "Do you have a brother or something?" And I was like, I lied and I said, "Yeah," just because I was like, "What?" I was just trying to figure out what he wanted to say. Because if I said no, I can play people. I know that it's not going to talk about it. So he goes, "Oh yeah, because I think I made fun of your brother." But he was making fun of me. I'm like, "Oh yeah, thanks, asshole." But he got T-boned by a car and died. Right down the street from here.
Oh, great.
Yeah, apparently she got, they were tied up. I had the link in my thing. Now, hold on. I screenshotted it because I know I'm horrible at finding stuff during the show.
What's her name?
Rosemary Chez. They're both tied up and shot multiple times. Execution style.
How do you spell the last name?
Chyz. She had no spotless record on her driver's thing. I don't know. This is boring, I guess. It's just weird, though. I was reading my newspaper, and I was like, I know what? You know what?
Is there a picture of her?
Here's what I did. I started crying. I was like, because I didn't even like remember knowing her, but it's like, oh, fuck. Could have been me.
She was only 19?
Mm-hmm. It happened,
In 2011.
Happened the year after graduation. Mm. I think she was in my graduating year. So I was really good friends with her sister, and then her sister just kind of like froze up. There's a couple people that like.
I thought this just happened.
And then there was another kid who his sister got like pushed down a flight of stairs or something.
Jesus fuck.
And died too. Yeah.
Well, there were like 40 kids from our school who also like died of drug overdoses.
And this kid is like, you know, it was one of those kids where it's like he was like one of the only like he was like openly gay before anyone would talk about it. Like, you know, I grew up in the 90s and stuff. He really, you know, people, it would be once in a while, but it would be the overly flamboyant and he would just have the hardest life. You know what I mean? So he made it to like 9th, 10th grade and then he started, you know, turning to drugs. You could tell he's like wearing sweatpants every day, but he's hanging out with all the popular kids. Then his sister dies and it's like, oh, fuck. And you don't see him for the longest time. And actually, I'm thinking of another guy, but yeah, same situation. It's hard for kids. Hard for kids.
I was like, oh shit, are
it's
we
just weird real? Though his fucking sister dies. What the fuck do you do? What do you do, Tori?
I don't know.
What do you do?
Because I've never been in that situation.
When we come back, we'll, I guess at the end of the show, we'll check to see what the lotion did anything. So how many, did you count, like, did you see what spots you had? Did you make a mental picture?
There was many.
Many?
Mm-hmm.
What are they?
I don't know. They're just, like, little red spots.
Look at mine and see if this is what you have.
Okay.
Oh, I gotta get somewhere. See, I'm gonna stand on a chair.
Okay.
All right, I want to make sure I'm not exposing too much to you, because this is for a lady. This is what a lady should be seeing. Actually, I feel uncomfortable sharing your mic. I'm not gonna show it to you.
Okay.
You don't deserve it.
Okay.
You're in a relationship with Hunter, and it's, I'm not going to mess with that. When we come back, we'll find out if Tori watches porn, how often she masturbates, and then I'm going to ask Tori, how do you start a relationship? Because I have no idea. I really don't.
Okay.
That's something I need to find out. And we'll do some news. But Tori, tell the audience what you'll tell them about.
I'm going to tell you about a new Oreo flavor coming out.
Ooh.
We'll tell you about a woman that got hit by a school bus.
Beep, beep.
And let's see about where you can have your wedding.
I'm trying to find a good car sound effect. Let's see if I can do it. Da, 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 da. Let's get ready for the show. Is that like a school bus sounds like? Ooh.
Oh, and then we're going to find out why a woman stabbed her boyfriend.
Heyo!
I like that one.
Ooh, spicy. It's a spicy meatball. All right, Rusty, stop drooling on me. We'll be right back. I can't do this fucking show anymore. No, you're not here. We already got Tim. Go ahead.
Okay.
Hello.
I'm a Hunter technically at an Applebee's.
Applebee's.
Well, in the first time I ever actually met him in real life, we like followed each other on Twitter because we had mutual friends and we went to the same high school. But like we used to do, well, he and his friends used to do like weekly trivia at Applebee's.
Applebee's. God, what a loser.
So I went one day, and that's when I met him for the first time. We didn't start dating until like a while after, though.
So you just knew about him from high school? You knew just like, what, you thought he was cute?
No, I...
Absolutely not.
Literally, like, I didn't even know him. I didn't even, like, know what he looked like. And, Gina, our mutual friend, one time was just like, hey, do you want to go to, like, this trivia thing that we do? And, like, I was like, sure. So it was me, her, Hunter, and this other kid named Tyler. And then we just, like...
Tyler Lem?
Tyler Nep.
No, it is.
He's a migrate. And then, yeah, we just, like, hung out and played trivia. And then I started going weekly, and that's when I started, like, developing, like, feelings for him.
So how do you like, because yesterday, what was your 2-year anniversary yesterday?
Yeah.
What was it the 2-year anniversary of?
Us, like, officially, like, him asking me to be his girlfriend.
So he asked you to be, how do you do that? It's like, it seems so weird. That's what you do? Because I've had all my relationships, I've never had that. And then what happens, it'll be like 2 years, I'll be hanging out with someone. And then they'll be, and afterwards, they'll be like, we weren't dating. And after, like, you know, you make out with someone and stuff.
Well, it was like,
if I just said make it, I was like stopped at making out. But it's like, you do more than that. You know
right.
What I mean?
Well, I don't know, because like we went on a couple dates and I didn't want to just assume that we were dating.
Mm-hmm.
And then finally, like.
If you like fool around with someone for like a year. What is that?
I don't know. That's why I like was very like, okay, are we dating or no?
So so how does the process start? You go out and then was there any kind of like what was there before he asked you out? Was there anything or he just asked you like kind of out of the blue?
No, we had been on 3 dates.
So what is that though?
It's like seeing each other as opposed
dating
to like,
comes before boyfriend and girlfriend, right? Is that how it works?
Yeah.
So dating, you wouldn't call it. Would you have to say, okay, let's go on a date? What is?
I guess so.
Or you just, or is it just let's go out to eat together?
No, like the way Hunter like asked me
fill out a form and say this is a date. Because I don't understand this.
I mean,
I feel
like
if someone's listening to the show, they don't understand it either.
I feel like it
is... like they're
is
huge losers if you listen to our show.
Like, if someone asks you out, like, hey, do you want to go out? I feel like that's a date.
That's
you don't
a date.
Have to say date. You know?
Yeah, that's I think...
If it's, like, if you think that it's, like, a, like, romantic relationship. Like, if I was like, hey, let's go out to eat. That's different. You know?
Well, say you weren't dating Hunter. Say we went out to eat, like, I guess it's because we work-ish together. Work, I love how I call those things work. But say you weren't doing the show regularly, you do the show once a month or whatever, and I say, hey, let's go out to eat. What would that be considered?
I feel like that'd just be considered, like, hanging out.
Okay.
Because I feel like you have to be, like, romantically interested in someone to think it's a date.
So he had 3 of asking you out to eat.
And he said, like, would you like to go on another date? Like, it wasn't, like...
After the first time. Mm-hmm. Hunter's trying to lock it in.
Yeah.
Steady.
Yeah.
Hunter's not letting this fish go away.
Yeah, pretty much.
I'm just like, fuck, this is my one chance.
Like, the first time he asked me, like, he's like,
let's
hey,
can I do a good Hunter? Probably not. It doesn't really sound like Hunter.
No.
Excited Hunter, though, a little bit, right?
It just sounds like you.
Excited Hunter, right? No, okay.
No, but, like, he asked me, do you want to go on a date?
Say Hunter's really, really excited, and he's jerking off by his name. Does it sound like Hunter a little bit? Yeah, a little bit, right?
No, he doesn't talk that fast.
That's what I mean. He's a little bit coked up or something. He's a little bit of drugs. You know, I'll say, I'm Hunter. No, I gotta get in my Hunter impression. Hey, guys. What's going on? Help me with my Hunter impression. I want to get on it.
I can't even do a Hunter impression.
Oh, this is pretty good. I'll talk like this. You have to just add a lot of oxygen into your mouth. Hey, guys. So, I'm Hunter. I'm about 23 years old, right? That didn't sound like
he's
him.
21.
No, he's 21. Jesus Christ. Hanging out with losers. So, 3 times of saying, okay, I want to go out to eat. And then he says, when does he ask you, do you want to be boyfriend and girlfriend?
At the end of our 3rd date, he asked
me. Hey, girlfriend. He asked you, and then did you kiss?
Of course we did. That's like all we did for the first like 3 months of our relationship.
What did he say to you?
We just like made out all the time. He was just like,
give me a kiss.
He was like, I think he was like, do you want to be my girlfriend or I want you to be my girlfriend or something. And I was like, of course I do.
So then when you leave and you kiss?
Hmm?
When you leave and you kiss? Was that was that Applebee's? I was at Applebee's with Tori.
We always kissed all the time. Wherever we
No,
were.
The first time.
Oh, the first time we kissed was
we always kissed. Hey, friend.
The first time we kissed was New Year's Eve.
Next time I see Hunter. Come here, Hunter.
Here's my first New Year's kiss.
But you said you kissed after the first or the third date. Right? Am I missing something? How do I miss something on my own show?
No, I don't understand this. That wasn't the first time we kissed after our third date.
That was?
No.
We kissed before then?
Yeah.
When did you... So, okay. Oh, my... Oh, my God, Tori. You are a little whore.
What?
Holy shit.
What are you talking about?
Before you even asked to be your boyfriend, girlfriend? Kiss... Exactly, chat room.
What?
No, I'm a little shocked at you, Tori.
What? It wasn't anything like... We didn't fuck.
Oh, my God.
We just kissed.
No, so, okay, so you, trivia happened. Do you guys, are you kissing at trivia?
No.
When did you guys start kissing? You laugh. Wasn't that more than that?
It was, okay, so our first kiss, we
what
were hanging out.
Was it the first date?
No, it was before the first date. That's like...
How do you kiss somebody before you go on a date with them? I don't understand that.
Okay, it was at a New Year's Eve party.
I mean, I understand, okay, you're hanging out. Like, I did that when I was a kid. You know, you're hanging out at someone's house, you end up making out on a couch.
Yeah, exactly.
So that's what happened?
Kind of. But we were both really drunk, and it was New Year's Eve, and we were, like, each other's New Year's kiss.
Did you guys go there as a date together?
No.
You said, oh, hey, do you want to go to New Year's scene?
No, it was just, like, a bunch of friends who
and
got
you
together.
And you got invited separately?
Well, I mean, we're a part of the same friend group.
Okay.
So we were all invited.
Hmm. Yeah, Tori's a whore. Jesus Christ.
I'm not a whore. It's not true. Cock. I hate cock.
What was that, Tori?
One must die.
All right, sorry. Was that loud for you?
What? Cock.
Adjust my headphones on.
Cock.
All right, good. My headphones are perfect. But then I can't hear myself. I feel like I'm lower than my cock.
Cock.
How do I make cock? Oh, that's why. Jesus Christmas. I just blasted. I apologize. All right, someone's technical difficulties. We'll go back to Tori being a whore in a second. All right, let's do a cock check real quick.
Cock.
All right, perfect. Sorry. All right, so New Year's, you guys are like, hey, we're making out. How do you guys make out? Is it like everyone's kissing and you're like, we're huge losers. Let's just kiss each other? Or
no, not really.
What happened? Can you tell me what happened?
Like, we had been hanging out all night and then like the countdown happened and we just started kissing.
Did you guys hold hands before then or?
Hold hands?
I don't know.
What are you talking about?
So
no.
You guys are just like, hey, instead of high five, and you guys are just kissing each other? I don't understand it.
Well, okay, like, there was a lot of, like, we were talking. Okay, we were talking. We were talking.
What does that mean, though? Tori's doing the bunny crow,
like, before that, we were, like, we kind of knew we were interested in each other.
How, though?
But, like, nothing, because we were, like, talking, and we would, like...
Trivia?
Like, flirt, and we would hang out, like, alone.
So you guys would be at trivia, be like... Hey, who does Hunter want to bang? A, Tori, B, Gina. Is it? Oh, it was a horrible joke. And everything lined up to all the sound effects, and I just fucked up my own joke. Does true or false? Hunter wants to bang Tori. True. But how do you guys know you want to like each other?
We told each other.
How do you guys know you want to like each other? So you just tell each other?
Yeah.
All right. I feel like it's so much more complicated than that.
It's not.
For me, it was. Not like that. Like Tori, Jesus Christ.
You also want different things in your relationship.
What do I want? Please tell me.
You know. Just want someone to come over to bang and then leave.
I want a blizzard.
I want a blizzard.
I want to kiss all of you. Why is it so large?
Airbutt. Ugh. No, I honestly don't want that. I don't know what I want, Tori. I want you, babe. I want you, babe. God, I'm fucking pissed your grandpa's in here right now.
What are you talking about?
I had this bit for like a month. It just doesn't work because the person I want to play your grandpa is so busy.
Good.
God, this show is...
Stay busy.
Super weird. Do some news, and then we got to check back with the Elotion. It's getting towards the end of the show.
All right.
Do a little bit of news, and then we'll check back on our Elotion. Do you want to do that?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. A woman stabs her boyfriend for turning down a threesome with a woman they met at the dog park. A woman in Arizona wanted her boyfriend to have a threesome with a woman they met at the dog park last month, but he turned it down, so she stabbed him with a pair of scissors. Earlier this month, when she brought up the idea of inviting their acquaintance over to fulfill one of their shared fantasies, her boyfriend turned it down because he claimed to feel ill. That's when an argument started. The verbal argument turned physical, resulting in the man getting stabbed. The woman was charged with felony assault.
What number are you doing? When did you just do?
Where does it show the number?
I have no idea. Doesn't say the number.
26.
26! All right. Now what are you doing?
Now I'm doing
26.
Number 33.
33!
The newest Oreo flavor will have exploding candies in the cream.
Ooh, hello.
You're not going to believe this, but Oreo is releasing another new flavor. Yeah, what's new? The next limited edition flavor is called Firework Oreos, and they look like plain old regular Oreos, but with a slight twist. Little red and blue exploding candies like Pop Rocks are mixed in with the cream. As far as we can tell, they aren't actually Pop Rocks, since the package just calls them, quote, popping candy. There's no word on when they come out, but based on the firework thing, we're guessing it'll be around July 4th. Good one.
Bingo!
Oh, shit.
Bingo. I love to go bingo, bingo, bingo. I want to bingo. No song break for you guys.
I'm trying to find the Taco Bell one.
Oh god, I want Taco Bell.
Me too.
There's the Oreos.
Ooh, a new sex toy warmer takes your self-pleasure to another level. There's a new bag you can buy that plugs into the wall and heats up, and it's specifically designed to keep sex toys warm. The creators say this device will provide sex toy enthusiasts with an effective and discreet way to warm sex toys and take sexual pleasure to heightened levels. The warmer is approximately 13 inches by 6 inches and looks like a clutch handbag.
Hey, when people say wiener.
That's number 24.
Tori. Do you masturbate? Oh, I'm going to save it for next week.
There's a new contest where you can win a wedding at Taco Bell.
Oh my god.
Ryan, do you want to get married to me at Taco Bell?
Here comes me.
Like and subscribe if Ryan should marry me at Taco Bell.
I want to get married at Taco Bell. I want to marry you, Bean Burrito. I love you, Bean Burrito, with no cheese.
Are you lactose intolerant or something?
I get diarrhea when I eat cheese. I do not like cheese.
Same.
Do not like that cheese, cause it comes out green in my stool. Is that all?
Anyways, when you were a little girl lying in bed dreaming of your wedding one day, did you picture yourself surrounded by a Gordita Supreme, cinnamon twists, and a giant cups of Mountain Dew? If so, your fairy tale could come true. Taco Bell is running a new contest where you can get married at Taco Bell. Now, it's not just any Taco Bell. It's a fancier one in Las Vegas, and it's actually got a classic Vegas wedding chapel inside. To enter the contest, just post a photo or video on Twitter or Instagram about, quote, Taco Bell's role in your love story, and use the hashtag Love and Tacos Contest. You'll win a trip for six to Vegas, catered dinner at Taco Bell, and more.
You are one pathetic loser.
I agree.
Imagine. That was 32,
if
by the
you
way.
You can imagine. Did we do four stories so far?
Probably.
Who cares? All right, do the bus one because you said you would. You promise!
Oh, shit, I forgot about it.
Don't you forget about the bus. The bus.
So find it.
That's Tori's boobs. Sorry, Tori. They're out there and I just wanted to grab them.
Oh, not funny.
Give me kiss, boobs. When was the first time he got in those? It was beautiful.
Who?
Yours.
What are you talking about? talking about?
Your boob. When did Hunter get at those boobs?
Pretty early on. A woman got hit by a school bus and survived. A 43-year-old woman in Brooklyn was crossing the street last Friday when she got hit by a school bus. It was a short bus, not a full-size one. She was trying to run across the street while it was turning and got clotheslined by one of the side mirrors. There's security footage where it looks like she gets run over by one of the wheels, but luckily that didn't happen. It just pushed her about 10 feet down the road while she was pinned under the bumper. Holy shit. Which is probably the only reason she survived.
What number was that?
Three.
I still want to get married at Taco Bell. I love you, slushies, but sometimes you are out of the ones I want. Oh my god, me and the people at Taco Bell have such a fun time together. We always talk. I'm going to marry this one lady at Taco Bell. She has about three teeth. Her name is, I don't know. She talks about her mom wanting to move in with her and have her. Her mom wants her to take care of her. It's amazing. I love it. I love the stories I have with random people, and they all know me too. I'll be on the thing, and she'll like interrupt someone. She'll have the intercom on, and I guess you can hear even if you're not on the thing. I guess it just so that way people are preparing the food can hear. So someone will be like, you know, what do you want? What do you want? I say, oh, you know, I say a thing and they my order's already ready kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll say that and then she'll interrupt her to be like, oh, okay, I'll look at it. Hello, honey! How many you want today? And you can tell just by the amount of, you can tell how she talks, how many teeth she has. It's under about, you can't tell exact amounts, but you can tell like either 1 to 6. 6 to 12 or 12 to 36, how many teeth they actually have, and she's in about the 6 to 12 category. But she's cool. Taco Bell, I love it. Alright, we gotta get to some things. You go in the bathroom and see what that lotion did. Do you want me to do me first or you first?
I'll go.
Alright, go in the bathroom. So before the break, Toy applied lotion to her butt. Aveeno Extra Healing. And we're going to see if it has any kind of effect on the bumps that she has on her butt, she says. What are they, like pimples?
I guess so, sort of, for lack of a better term.
All right, Tori's getting up. Welcome, making her way over to the studio. Luckily, the bathroom's right next to the studio. This is amazing.
Okay.
All right, here we go. Wait, let's see. I'm going to turn the mic on in there. Can we hear you?
Can you hear me?
Yay! Okay. All right, we can do Tori's in the bathroom with a beautiful patented bathroom microphone. She is in the bathroom. Lest you think we're lying. Go ahead. What? So what are you doing? Describe what you're doing.
I'm looking at my butt in the mirror.
All right. How's it look?
It looks good.
Does it look better?
It looks a little better, to be honest. It's only about fucking with you.
It's only about 45 minutes, too.
Yeah. I mean, not like completely, but a little bit.
It's good, though? I only had one mark on mine. I'm curious to see what mine did. Mine usually doesn't do anything about it. What are you doing in there?
Pulling my pants back up.
Okay. It takes a while, doesn't it? Wow. Terry's got a thong on, by the way. Did you have to pull your thong down when you looked, or no?
No.
All right. I'll believe you.
No, why would I?
I don't know. I would. I gotta go look now. Mine. Oh. All right. Let's see. Going.
Put your headphones on. You're a broadcaster. Right, do you have to pee? By the way, I want to hear you pee.
I really do have to pee.
All right. After this, we'll pee on microphone, then we'll end the show. We'll never do the show again. Honestly, before, there was like a lot, it was a little bit redder, and now it's less. But I didn't expect that much of it.
So it worked?
Yeah, a little bit.
A little bit, that's pretty much what I said.
The problem is I only do it for once when I remember to do it, and then I won't do it again, so it's not, you know what I mean, it's going to keep rebuilding, I think, so.
Mm-hmm, definitely.
All right, I'm going to adjust this microphone so it's more pointed down at the toilet.
I'll get back in the studio.
I have to pee. So I'm going to pee now?
Yeah, I don't know if this will be funny. I might kind of be gross that way.
this gonna be a long pee?
No.
I might get sick and probably not. I just don't know if I want to hear this.
Okay, then I take the mic out because I'm
about
to pee.
We'll go pee anyways, and I'll just turn off the mic if it's not funny.
Okay. That means I have to pee at the door.
I won't look. Oh, shit. What are you doing? Tori's not. Tori just broke the studio. She did. She broke the studio.
Okay.
Right, go ahead. Can you before you take your before you pull your pants on, can I snap a picture of you with the microphone?
What are you talking about? Sure, snap a picture.
All right, hold on.
I don't even know what the fuck you're talking about.
Well, I don't want to see your vagina and snap. I'm coming in there, you're right?
Yeah.
All right, hold on. I want to get a picture of the microphone in the bathroom. All right, now we're both in the bathroom together. All right, hold on. The problem is with this microphone, it has this toilet paper roll attached to it, so it looks bad. Hold on. Let's see. I'm unscrewing this thing. I'm rescrewing this microphone stand on. By the way, subscribe to us on Periscope. Monday, Tuesday, 11 a.m. 8 a.m. Pacific, is that right?
Yes.
Pacific? All right, let's see. Alright, hold on. Alright, I took a picture for Snapchat.
Okay.
Alright, Tori's gonna pee on the microphone now, and we're gonna see if it's funny or not.
Ready?
Yeah, go ahead. I think I'm like 3 years old. This shit's funny to me.
It's funny to me, too.
Yeah, I just put a big bill for this new audio system, and it's all worth it now. I swear. We would not have been able to do this before. This is awesome. What are you doing? You got toilet paper now? What was that? Was that your thong? Yeah.
This is so weird.
That's awesome. Oh, he's got a thong on. That's fucking cool. I feel like Bobby. Don't get close. Look at her. She's washing her hands. Good for her. Yeah. Next week we'll come back. Tori, we'll talk about Tori. Actually, Tori's gonna sing the song she sang at her grandpa's funeral. It's gonna be beautiful. So we'll hear that. And I think that's a show. Get back here. How you doing, Tori?
I'm good.
Did you wash your hands?
Yeah. Wrong one.
Tori's turning off all the lights. Alright, get back in here. We gotta end the show.
I just peed on fucking mic.
You peed,
don't rush me.
You peed on the microphone?
Yeah, I peed on the mic. What? I don't want to know.
God, you keep tripping over everything. Did you actually break the set? Let's see what you did.
No.
This is like this electrical block. Tori almost knocked, took us off air.
I think I'd never been in this room before.
I know. Alright. I'll tweet out the picture too of Tori peeing on the well, she didn't pee though. But
no, I was just sitting.
Just sitting, but just don't get too excited, Bobby. Alright, that's a show. What did you learn, Tori?
Bathroom mics are funny.
Next week, again, I'm gonna make empty promises of your grandpa being here. Maybe it'll happen, maybe it won't. Maybe you'll sing your song. And we'll find out about Tori's porn and masturbation habits. So, what did you? What's the? Well, how would you summarize the show, Tori?
How'd I summarize the show?
Whoa! Do a song. Like an angel.
The show is very. I don't know. All
right.
It's fun. We have fun here. And what word am I looking for?
I don't know.
I don't know. What? Cock. Oh, I'm not good with words.
Here's Tori's final words.
Have you ever seen a movie where the dog is plays soccer?
Yes.
Oh, God, Tori.
It's called Air Bud, I believe. That's the one.
I still love this. My name is Air Bud.
Oh.
So good. Hey, shorty, yeah, that's where I stay. Heard you was a lame boy, get up out my face. And my ex keep calling sweater, she be in the way. And I need a thick red bone, shorty where I lay. Bad bitch in LA, tell me that she made the trip. Shorty bad as hell, yeah, with them college journalists. But every fucking word. $15 off. Very beautiful. All right, Tori. Very good. Thank you, Barry. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. All right, we're done. We good? Did we do this? Cash money. Air Bud. My name is Air Bud.